Now, I'm supposed to be biased because I'm a TNA fan, but you guys know me better than that by now. You know that I've given enough TNA shows bad reviews over the last 7 months to prove that I'm not just some brain-dead mark who's going to praise them to the moon no matter what they do. So please believe me when I say that there is no way you can look at this card on paper right now and tell me that this does not have the potential to be the best pay-per-view of 2008 so far. I mean, like always, yeah, the execution of it is going to be a big factor, but this is looking like one hell of a show right now. If you miss it, you'll regret it. Order Victory Road. I'll talk to you when it's over.
Come on, Cage, now it's time to blow doors down. I hear your chables, now it's time to blow doors down. Light up the stage, cause it's time for a showdown. We'll bend you over, then we'll take it around town. Now we got to blow this fucking down. It's gonna rape me if we do not blow doors down. Come on, Cage, cause it's time to blow doors down. We'll find Brian, it's time for the smack. Hey, it's a great star, Beelzebub. Come on, Cage, you're coming with me!
Anyone who hates on Victory Road can kiss my ass. This pay-per-view was awesome! And I shouldn't even have to say why this pay-per-view was so awesome, because this is a show that speaks for itself. So, instead of doing my usual run-through of a show like I usually do, I want to talk about something else that's infuriating me right now. After the show ended, I came on here to see what other people were saying, and since I enjoyed it so much, I somewhat naively believed that other people would feel the same way. But what do I see? I see comment after comment of people saying, well, the finish of the main event sucked, or it was a great show until the finish of the main event ruined it, or the ending made no sense, how can Booker T be the world champion? Listen up, you nimrods. I shouldn't have to explain this to anyone, because it should be perfectly obvious what happened if you got two brain cells to rub together, okay? The ending of the main event was booked the way it was for three reasons. To send the Houston fans home happy, to keep the feud with Booker T going for a while longer without a title change, and three, to set up Joe versus Sting. Is Booker T the world champion right now? Of course not. Him walking out with a belt doesn't mean squat. When Bret Hart goaded Bill Goldberg into spearing him, and Goldberg knocked himself out because Bret was wearing body armor, and then Bret pinned him and made the count himself, 1, 2, 3, did that mean that Bret really beat Goldberg? Of course not, because Bret wasn't an official referee, and neither is Charmel. And without an official referee, the belt doesn't change hands. Charmel did what she did because it was the only way that she could get the match to end and get her husband out of there before Joe woke up and crippled them. And why did they take the world title with them when they left, you ask? Because they're heels, and that's what heels do. The whole thing would make sense if you just use your heads for a minute, but instead you just focus on the negative and that's all you can see. Well, now I'm going to tell you why you're wrong and why this show kicked ass. First, 12-man elimination match. I don't have the words to describe how awesome this match was, so I'm just going to say this. If you buy the replay of Victory Road, you pay $30, you order the replay, and your pay-per-view provider has technical difficulties or something, and it craps out after 30 minutes, so you only see the first match on the show, you would still get your money's worth. It was that good. It was a half-hour highlight reel, and nothing else needs to be said about that. Ultimate X. In the biggest holy shit moment of the night, Kaz climbed to the top, the very top, of one of the stanchion pole towers, did a flying leg drop onto Daivari at the center of the X with both of them crashing down to the mat. One of the craziest spots I've seen in years. Full Metal Mayhem. You had Christian doing a high crossbody up the top of the tower onto three guys, AJ somersaulting over the rope, diving off the ladder, people going through tables left and right. And then after Christian and Rhino got taken out, the last 5 minutes was all AJ. And he got put over like a superhero because he almost won the match all on his own. Jay Lethal, Sanjay Dutt, that was another great match. And so what if SoCal Val got involved? The whole thing made sense in the storyline. Val obviously liked Sanjay before the wedding, and now even though he ruined her wedding, she doesn't want him to get hurt. Gee, I wonder what that could mean. So Jay Lethal gets frustrated by this. He gets distracted, and Sanjay capitalizes, gets the pin, and scores the biggest win he's ever had in TNA. Taylor Wilde and Awesome Kong. Tell me you didn't jump out of your seat when almost 300 pounds of Awesome Kong went up to the top turnbuckle and Taylor sent her flying. Tell me you weren't legit shocked when Abyss came out to save Taylor of all people. Abyss of all people. I mean, then there was Gail and Angelina and Fans Revenge. Both those matches were solid. And then the main event. That thing was great. The whole point of it was about showing that Booker T had bitten off more than he could chew with Joe and that Joe had finally snapped. They were reestablishing Joe as a cold-hearted badass, which I absolutely loved because Joe was always better as a heel anyway, and that's what got him so over in TNA in the first place. Joe had that match won. He won the match. Everybody knew it. And it was beautiful, man. He didn't just beat Booker T. He destroyed Booker T in his hometown in front of his friends, his family, and while Booker's wife was crying at ringside begging for Joe to stop. Which gave Sting a reason to get involved, which sets up Sting versus Joe at Bound for Glory, probably. What is so hard to understand about all that? I mean, you guys can't appreciate it for what it was. All you do is complain that the whole show is ruined because the main event didn't have a clean finish or some crap like that. You don't say anything about all the positives, all the awesome effort, Kaz and Daivari almost killing themselves in Ultimate X. Damn it! Look at all the good, you morons! How can you get hung up on the one thing you didn't like when TNA gives us a show like this? Victory Road was the best TNA pay-per-view in a long time. I would even say this was better than Bound for Glory 2007. And the fact that there's people out there who can't see that just makes me wonder why these people even watch wrestling, because they're never going to be happy with it. Jesus Christ could descend from the sky and book Hard Justice next month to be the greatest wrestling show since time began, and these people would still be looking for stuff to bitch about. And I just don't understand that. Even the most hardcore WWE fanboys had to appreciate what TNA did with Victory Road. So, in conclusion, yeah, I kind of like this pay-per-view.